just one day until British voters head to the polls, Prime Minister Boris Johnson is driving home his message that he will get Brexit done by bulldozing through a wall of styrofoam bricks painted with the word gridlock. His Conservative Party is on track to win a majority in Parliament, though not as large as once predicted. Meanwhile, Labour leader Jeremy Corbyn is backing away from Brexit to focus his campaign on healthcare and education policy reforms. He's trying to claw back the lead from the Conservatives. So let's turn to CNN Simon Cullen, joining me now live from London. Good to see you again, Simon. So the majority for Conservatives appears to have narrowed from 68 to 28 seats. That's according to the new YouGov forecast. But that still leaves them in a very good place, doesn't it? So what's the latest on those numbers and all about this?
Yes, Rosemary, it does leave them in a very good place. As you say, that gap has narrowed in the space of the last month. So we've seen it from 68 majority for the Conservatives down to 28. Let's have a look at the raw numbers, though. The Conservatives are on track to win 339 seats out of a parliament of 650. Labour on 231. The Scottish National Party on track for 41. And the Liberal Democrats on 15. Interestingly, the Conservatives are doing particularly well in Brexit voting areas, whereas they're struggling in London, which is an area where Labour expects to pick up a few seats. Two major points to point out, though, here is that this is a national poll, so sometimes it doesn't get into the details of each individual constituency and the issues affecting the local vote. And two is that there is a margin of error with all polling. And even though this was done with 100,000 interviews over 10 days, even the pollsters themselves say the coalition, so the Conservative majority could be even bigger. Or on the flip side, it could still be a hung parliament if the numbers are on the lower end of the scale.
Yeah, that seems incredible at this point, doesn't it? So what are the issues that are influencing people's votes right now?
Well, there's a few major themes that have been running through this campaign. Undeniably, Brexit is a big one. And this is an issue where there is a stark difference between the major parties. Boris Johnson, the Conservative leader, promising to get Brexit done, as we saw with the video just a moment ago. And, of course, on the flip side, Labour leader Jeremy Corbyn is promising to go back to the EU, renegotiate the withdrawal deal, and then put that deal to the people in the form of a referendum. There's also the issue of public spending and the National Health Service, a difference there in terms of promises about the future. And, of course, there's the issue of trust and leadership, both major party leaders facing particular challenges here. For example, Boris Johnson has come under fire over the veracity or the truthfulness of some of his promises. For example, 50,000 new nurses, he said. Turns out it's only 31,000 new nurses. And of course, the Conservatives came under fire a few weeks ago over their rebranding of their Twitter account to make it look like an independent fact-checking service. On the flip side, Labour leader Jeremy Corbyn has come under fire over the believability of some of his manifesto promise costings and, of course, some persistent problems over how he has dealt or not dealt with anti-Semitism within the Labour Party. So there's a lot of issues that voters are weighing up as they go to the polls. And, of course, the big day is tomorrow.